£1 million ransom request. Yes, it happened. Right, let me tell you. This is on our webpage, brimardon.co.uk, which is where we've been for the last, 25 years or something. We are there, yes. So let me explain about the £1 million ransom request. I'll explain a bit about what's happening now. Right, so we obviously had very successful websites. We were the, just to clarify this, we were the biggest business ever to be a tipping service. We were larger than anyone else has ever been large. So there was one number one, and that was Brimardon. It was bigger than anybody else, I can assure you, not only by the amount of members, but by the amount of money, by everything, really. The most success. Nobody's had more success than us, and nobody's had more profits than us, in my opinion. But I can only go on the figures. Still got all the spreadsheets. Anyway, let's get back to the £1 million ransom request. So, what had happened was, I think it was 2018, might slightly been before that. 2018, we used to have people doing the websites. Problem. What's the problem? You better have a look at the website. It was totally blank, or there was a, you know, contact us. Obviously, what had happened, and I'll just put it there, look. You know, it happens to everybody. And it says in 2019, a business will fall victim to a ransomware attack every 14 seconds. And it was what you call ransomware attack. They take over, these Russians take over your website, can't do out about it. Multi-million pound firms have been taken over, small firms, medium firms, and it just happens, you know, they target you. And what they do then is they try to extort money off you in order to get it back up and running. And the £1 million thing come about. And at the end of the day, what we had to do is to transfer everything. The only thing on the website, we used to do, you know, we used to put stuff on there because people can access it. It was easiest way for everybody to go, and it was slightly a bit different. We still used to run a phone, but not a premium rate or anything. And what had happened was we transferred everybody over to the Tic Tac Brimardon one, and we were left without the Brimardon because they'd taken it over. You couldn't do a thing unless you paid them money. And what we had to do is really, people, it just went blank type of thing. People thought we went bust, we're on the foreman's going bust, it's all over, all this kind of rubbish. And that's what happens, but sometimes you can't do anything about it, you know, it could be beyond your control if somebody's grabbed hold of your website. So what we actually did is to put it all over somewhere else. We didn't lose, you know, we didn't lose any data, so to speak. We only lost all the results on the website and videos and everything. That was all taken because they'd just withdrawn everything. And we knew we weren't going to get it back because obviously we weren't going to pay any kind of ransom. So it took a while. They took the web page or web address, couldn't do anything. And we had to really just wait, you know, because we weren't going to get into dialogue on paying them. And they must have realized, because, you know, at the end of the day, they can't keep that lock on for long. So obviously it was released, and we got it released, and we ended up back with the web page. So what we did in that time, we were available for anybody to join, which was, it taught us a lesson, really, because obviously we, with being one of the largest, we used to get, you know, hammered on the prices, and we used to keep all the members that joined us for years. They still stopped with us. You know, we contacted them, we knew who they were, and that was fine. But we weren't taking on new members. And at the end of the day, we found that the prices were amazing because we really were available to the public. When I look back to Derby 2020, that's why we got the 25-1 winner, is because we were available. If we were publicly available, that would have been 16-1 shot, if not shorter. And that's how it affects you sometimes. The Cheltenham stuff, has been fantastic, unbelievable prices. Just the normal success that we have. And I'll put them results up, and our Cheltenham mode going back over this, what, last 10 years. Nobody can beat that. And what you've got is, we're back up on the website, brimardon.co.uk, but we're not really, haven't been taking on any members. We might do in the future. There's loads of tipsters out there, isn't there? Twitter and Facebook and YouTube, you name it. It's all out there. The Racing Post, for some reason, you know, like, they earn good money out of all of us. But I tell you what, they were the filter to save punters. People don't realise this. They were the filter. You can't believe the hoops we had to join. Everything was covered by the Advertising Standards Authority. And they even had a guy at the Racing Post that used to have to do it. So they had to employ somebody. We had a proofing sheet. Everything had to be proofed. Not only with stakes, but the prices. But even a photo of the price. You know, a photo of the price that was on Odds Checker or whatever. You know, so that's how regulated it was. We had to have everything in place. You can't just say, well, I'll have, you know, 16 to 1 on Betfair. That wasn't allowed. No, Betfair prices weren't allowed. You had to go on a publicly available, like, Odds Checker, take a photo, and that had to go in with your proofs. So, you know, it was available. And everything was down, not only the points or how much money, and they kept a check. They actually kept spreadsheets. It's amazing. So the Racing Post did, you know, because when I used to speak to the people at the Post, they used to get 50 requests a week for people advertising, every Tom, Dick and Harry. Well, they kept all them away. So you were left with they wanted people they could trust. Somebody joined us, they knew we weren't going to rip them off. We were going to give them what we said we'd give them, you know, and they got a good service at the end of the day. It's very rare we got complaints of money back and things like that. And I'll cover that in later videos of actually what went on, because it was amazing what went on. Absolutely. I've never heard the stories that people told me. And I probably spoke to, I reckon I spoke to 50,000 people over the years who wanted to join. We like talking to them because it gives us an insight into what people want. But I could work out whether people were winning or not within 2 minutes of speaking to them. All they had to do was speak, and I knew whether they were any good for us or whatever. Anyway, going back to the Racing Post, they did the filtering, and now you've got Twitter, you've got all this other tipping stuff. And I tell you what, it's like the Wild West again, isn't it, really? There's no filter, there's that many lies, and no proofing. Excuse me, it's just gone mad. And Racing Post don't allow tipsters to advertise no more, and they made fortunes. I think it's because they wanted to bring their own stuff in. I saw that, I see where it was going a couple of years ago, but their own stuff is not very good. You haven't got full-time people. The journalists, nothing wrong with journalists, but, you know, they were brought up as journalists and then got into it. You know, it's a job, isn't it? You know, nothing wrong with that. But the people like yourselves who are professional gamblers, and it's a different ball game. It's a different ball game. Anyway, I'm not slating the Racing Post because, like I say, they used to use the filters, and all our results were fantastic. And at the end of the day, we're the only one still to have an Advertising Standards Authority that we made 57,000. I'll put that on the website and put it on a video as well. Things like that, it'll never be done again, and it never been done before. The only tipster ever in the history of horse racing to prove a profit. And I'll get back into that. And that's why I'm doing a few videos, because they've lost quite a lot. I've got loads more to put in, even some of the early stuff from early days. Anyway, I'll leave it at that. Catch you later.